Welcome everyone to this year's Viewpoint Collaborate Users Conference. A little bit different, we're all virtual, but we still have a great conference for you. We're really excited for you to participate in all the ProContractor sessions. We have some great sessions this year. And by being virtual, we've got over 300 ProContractor customers who are able to register and participate. So today I'm happy to kick off the ProContractor sessions. We're going to start with ProContractor in 2020, everything you need to know. We're going to dive into a couple of different things really around the roadmap, highlight some key products and feature functionality that we've added over the last 12 months or so. All right, before we get started into the presentation, we have a couple of housekeeping items to deal with. First up, is our standard disclaimer that we have. Really, the disclaimer just talks about this is our direction today, but we obviously have the right to make different decisions as we move forward. The chat capability. So inside of your window on the right-hand side is the ability to chat. We're going to ask as we go through the session for you to participate. Saying some feedback and comments in there. It's also how we'll handle the question and answers at the end of the session. So as we're going through, if you have a question, jot it down into the chat and then we'll tackle it at the end of the session in Q&A. Last but not least of our housekeeping items is our CPE credits. So for those of you who are wanting their CPE credit, you have to stay for the full session. At the end of the session, in the chat window will be a survey link. You'll need to take that survey link, open it up in a new browser, complete the survey, and that will get you registered for your CPE credits. So stay through the session. At the end of the session in chat will be the link. You can take that, complete that survey, and that'll get you registered for your CPE credits from that standpoint. All right. Hello, everyone. My name is Michael Upton, Senior Product Manager here at Viewpoint. My role here is to oversee the ProContractor product line. And so that includes the Accounting Project Management Suite, our PC mobile application, and our estimating solutions. My role is to oversee the product vision, delivery and execution on the roadmap, and delivery of those features and functionality to you. So I'm excited to kick us off today and walk through a couple of things from a ProContractor standpoint. So today in our session, we are going to talk about the roadmap and our vision and different components and where we are headed. Then we're going to take a snapshot of a couple of key features and functionality that we've added over the last 12 months and give you some in-depth look at some of them. And then we're also going to cover a variety of different ways that you can stay engaged with us as we continue to move forward with ProContractor. And then the last thing on the agenda, we're excited to announce or tease anyway, ProContractor One. So we will cover that when we get there. Let's dive into the strategy and roadmap. As I talk to customers, several times a month, I'll be talking to customers and they'll tell me, well, ProContractor's going away, or ProContractor's in maintenance mode. Oh, you're sunsetting ProContractor. You guys aren't doing anything. You aren't helping me manage my business. You're not adding new feature functionality. So I want to tell you that's completely wrong. We have full development teams rolling across the ProContractor product suite. We're in active development. We're continuing to add 2 to 3 releases a year where we will continue to add feature functionality into the ProContractor product suite across the entire product line, whether it's PC mobile, estimating, the accounting project management solutions. So we are full bore. There've been no conversations about putting ProContractor in sunset mode or maintenance mode. We fully believe in ProContractor and the product, and we're continuing to invest and deliver new feature functionality and value to you, our customers. Not going to cover all of these. This is a little bit of an eye chart, and so is the next slide. But this is a snapshot of the features that we have delivered over the last two years or so. When you add them all up, it's worth well over 1,200 suggestion box votes through all of these features. And we'll talk about the suggestion box here later. So as you can see, and I'll go to the next slide, we have done a significant amount of work across all components of the ProContractor product suite, the accounting, project management, PC mobile, estimating. We've done a lot of work, and we're going to keep doing that. If some of these things you have missed, we're going to talk about ways that they engage and know where and when we have new releases and all the feature functionality that's in it. So some of you have used the features. So this is your first opportunity to use the chat feature there on the right-hand corner. So for those of you who have used some of the new features, ones have been most beneficial or helpful to you. So go ahead and just put that in the chat. That's great feedback for us. Obviously, we love feedback and saying, hey, that was a great feature. That went, not so much, or didn't necessarily add value to my business. We want to hear that feedback, and that helps us continue as we move when we talk about and try to figure out what new functionality to add into the product. So go ahead and add that in the chat, and we'll take care of that and review that later. So from a product vision standpoint, when we're really looking at trying to decide what features functionality to add to the next release of ProContractor, we always bump it up really against our components of what we believe the vision of ProContractor should be. And so there are five. So the first one is usability. And usability not only encompasses sort of the look and feel of ProContractor, but really also the user experience, right? It's key, right? What we're trying to do is add capabilities to make your daily interaction with ProContractor easier, more efficient. Last thing that we want is make it harder for you to do your job. So we're always looking for ways, right? So if we're doing a new feature functionality and in one step, what's the step? Not if it has to be more than one step, let's make it easy for you to go to from step one to step two, et cetera, right? Really trying to make that easier, more efficient for you, to make it easier for you to manage your business on a day-to-day basis. The next one is customer success. Customer success is really about continuing to round out and add functionality to help you meet your business needs. The business world is always changing, always new opportunities to manage your business, new opportunities out there. We're always looking for things to continue to add to the ProContractor portfolio that will add value and continue to allow you to compete in the business world. Next up is integration. And integration, we're looking for key components or key strategic partners that we can really leverage their expertise that allows us then to focus in other areas and provide additional feature functionality back inside of the ProContractor suite. So for example, one of these is Atrix, and we'll talk about Atrix here in a moment. Atrix is a compliance and regulatory reporting solution. They live and breathe federal and state level compliance reporting requirements, filings, and all of that type of stuff. So what we've done is we've built that integration where we've done the integration. We can pass the information that Atrix needs to be able to do it. Then Atrix handles all of that. And what that then allows us to do, rather than worrying about the latest electronic filing capability that the federal government has or state of Oregon has or New York has or whoever, Atrix is already handling all of that, and we don't have any work to do. So then we can take the time, take that time that we would have had to go figure all that stuff out and do other things and add capabilities back in to the ProContractor product suite. The fourth is information access. Getting information out of the system to help you manage your business is critical. And so we're always looking for ways to provide new reports, provide new reporting capabilities, new views. We're looking at new ways to get the information out of the system to help you manage your business more efficiently and effectively. And last but not least is compliance, the one that no one really likes, but it's sort of part of the, all part of just doing business. So whether it's payroll, accounting requirements, regulatory with vendors, et cetera, right? We will always stay up to date and be able to comply with those various regulatory and compliance requirements. So where are we headed? So obviously, as we continue to plan each release, we're looking for features and functionality that covers one to many of those roadmap vision. We're also continuing to look in some key areas of research and evaluation or investigation. So the first one is team project management. So you have probably heard this from Viewpoint around their team project management solution that they launched just a few years ago. They've really done a lot of work in there. We're looking at ways that we can integrate that into ProContractor to really provide some additional value and capabilities from a project management perspective. HR management is another Viewpoint solution that's integrated into Spectrum and Vista. We're looking at ways that we can leverage that inside of the ProContractor suite. Here again, this is be able to manage onboarding, new jobs that are available, et cetera. Really be able to help you manage sort of the HR management component. Performance is another key aspect. We have clients who have been on the system for many years, lots of years of data. It's all starting to accumulate. We're always looking for ways to fine-tune and improve performance as we continue to get more and more data and larger data sets. From a field perspective, from a PC mobile perspective, we're looking at ways to capture more data in the field. Today, we can capture time, we can capture part of a daily field report. We're really looking at being able to expand that information and be able to capture more information out in the field and have that automatically sync back into the back office. So for our estimating product, we're looking at RS Means integration. For those of you who have been around for a little bit and have had estimating for a while, you know that we used to have an integration with RS Means. That business relationship ended a few years ago. We're in active conversations with RS Means about reestablishing that business relationship that will allow us to offer you the capabilities of integrating the RS Means data inside of the estimating product suite. Web services is another key component. Here again, we're looking at ways, strategic ways that we can extend ProContractor to help you help you really manage your business more and leverage new capabilities out there. So we're looking at web services in some key areas. Then obviously we have our usability and efficiency items along with, you know, just continuing to add feature functionality to help you manage your business. So we have a lot of work to do. I'm always pushing the dev teams to get more done. We are continuing to add feature functionality, continuing to add value to the product to help you manage your business better. All right, so now we're going to sort of transition and take a look at some key features and functionality that we've released over the last 12 months. So over the last year, we have delivered a lot of key pieces of functionality that really will help you make you more efficient, make your business more efficient, and make you stronger. And so what we're going to do is we're going to highlight a couple of these as we go forward, so you can see the value and how they can provide efficiency back into your business. So first up is e-payments. E-payments is our latest feature that we just released this past July. E-payments is an integration with one of our strategic partners, InvoicePay. E-payments solution is integrated inside of Vista and Spectrum, and now we're bringing it into ProContractor. E-payments is a new way to pay your vendors more efficiently, more cost-effectively, and allow you to pay your vendors the way that they would like to be paid, whether that's a physical check, whether that's ACH, or if they're willing to accept a virtual credit card. To highlight this, we're going to watch a quick video, and then I'll come back and we'll talk through some of the details.
Many contractors find themselves frustrated with the accounts payable payment process, as is one of the more time-consuming workflows for your back office. Not only does it take many hours per week to pay hundreds of vendors, but it's expensive, as well as full of risk, with you having to hold sensitive payment information for your vendors and suppliers. ProContractor's integration with financial technology provider InvoicePay offers a better and simpler way. With Viewpoint ePayments, powered by InvoicePay, ProContractor customers can improve their efficiency and reduce the cost of their overall AP processes. You can process all payment methods together in a single file and reduce or eliminate printing checks, giving a cost reduction of up to 75%. ePayments reduces your risk because you no longer need to collect or store vendor banking and payment data, as it is securely maintained and updated by InvoicePay. And ePayments provides you with a new revenue opportunity, whereby contractors can maximize rebates earned on payments settled via credit card. Today, ProContractor must generate payment files consisting of checks to be printed and mailed, ACH payments, and various credit service payments. With ePayments, ProContractor sends a single payment file to InvoicePay, who then processes the payment no matter how the supplier wishes to be paid. Contractors then get to enjoy new revenue flowing from maximized rebates received on their payables.
As we saw in the video, the ePayment solution is simple and integrated inside of ProContractor. Inside of ProContractor, your process to pay your vendors is exactly the same. You'll still select your invoices for payment just like you do today. When you go to pay those invoices, you're just going to select e-payments rather than computer check in this case. And at that point, ProContractor packages up all of that information and automatically sends it to InvoicePay for processing. InvoicePay will take all of that, will optimize it for payment. So they will reach out to all of your vendors, determine how they want to be paid. Do they want a physical check? Will they take an ACH? Are they willing to accept a virtual credit card? And so they'll get all those payments ready. Now, what you'll also have the capability to do in this is to have an additional approval process before those payments are actually sent out to those vendors. You can establish a variety of different rules. Say, for example, any payment over $5,000 has to have the owner sign off on, or the CFO, or whatever the case may be. Those rules can be set up with InvoicePay. And as payments come in, if they meet those rules, whoever's supposed to approve them will get notified for them to come into the InvoicePay website, be able to review those payments, and be able to approve those payments. You can also stop payments. You on hold, say, you know what, I don't want to make that payment. I actually want to avoid that payment. You can do all of that from the InvoicePay side. Once all of that has been approved and signed off on, those vendors will get paid. And however that they want, we get the information back inside of Contractor in terms of which vendors were paid, are there any payments on hold, are there payments that were voided. We get information in terms of how those vendors were paid and information about those payments. So you have a full audit trail. If there's any payment issues, right, invoice pay follows up on your behalf. So invoice pay will manage all that. You don't have to keep track of vendor account information anymore. Invoice pay will handle all of that from that standpoint. So that completely makes your process easier. No more putting check stock in the printer, no more folding, having to physically sign checks, stick them in an envelope, put a stamp on it, stick it in the mail, right? All of that goes away. Invoice pay handles all of that on your behalf. And then sort of the cream on top is you actually have the ability to get rebates back into you every month. And so based upon the vendors who are willing to accept the virtual credit card, you get a percentage of that back to you every month. So here's an example of three different contractors across our customer base. And these customers have utilized invoice pay. And what you see is the annual process savings. So that is just being more efficient inside of the AP department, right? So no more print or check stock. You're saving on toner, you're saving on stamps, envelopes, all of that type of stuff. The annual rebate, that is their cut of those vendors who are paid via virtual credit card. And then you get a total benefit. A lot of our customers who are utilizing the services, just the efficiency gains inside the AP makes it worthwhile. But then on top of get revenue coming back into the business, that is great news. And they're ecstatic about it. So if you're interested, want to learn more, visit Invoice Pay. They are in our virtual expo hall that you can get from our Conference Central. Go in there, go talk to them. They can get you set up and started on the path to integrating with the e-payment solution. Next up, I talked about this briefly, but Atrix. This is our other integration that we've done over the last 12 months. And this is really to provide regulatory reporting at the state and federal level for both US and then for Canada at the federal level. Atrix handles over 300 different reports. And so our integration is to package up the data that we have inside a ProContractor. And then Atrix takes that data and then will complete the reports appropriately. And so what you get is step-by-step guidance. So you pick a typical report. So in this case, it's the 941. What you get is Atrix will take all of the data that we've passed to it. It will take the form. It'll pre-fill all the information that we have. Once you have gone through, and Atrix will walk you through step-by-step of this form, it makes sure that you've completed everything. There's business logic within the form. It'll guide you through making sure line 3 times line 4 equals line 5, et cetera. It'll guide you through step by step of completing that form. Once you are done, you can print that out on your printer on plain paper, right? No more buying the forms and trying to print to the form. You can print that out from there. After you have printed the form, you can take that, sign it, and then you can send it off to the appropriate agency that needs that form. Now, Atrix also has a variety, is really a full stop shop. So all of that is included as part of Atrix. Atrix also has additional services. They will do e-filing both at the federal and state level on your behalf. Many more states are requiring that e-filing, whether, you know, as on a monthly basis, yearly basis, whatever the case may be. And so what would happen, for example, for e-filing, you complete the report as you walk through step step by step. There'll be an option at the end that says, do you want us to submit that for you? Atrix will then submit that form for you on your behalf. You would create an account with Atrix and provide them some additional details, and then they will go ahead and do that. They also provide print and mailing services at year end to employees and vendors for all their forms, whether it's W-2s, 1099s, all the ACA forms. Atrix can also do your tax deposits for your various states on your behalf. They can also provide electronic forms for your employees at year end. It's a full-stop shop available to you through Atrix. So if you want to learn more information about Atrix and all of their capabilities, visit Atrix in our virtual expo hall, or you can visit partner.atrix.com/procontractor, and you'll see all the details there. All right, next up on our features is multi-window support. And so this is one of the most commonly, requested and commented on. So as you know, inside ProContractor, when you start a new task, right, you get a new tab there at the top of the screen. You know, all of a sudden, I got 6, 7, 8, 10, 12 tabs across the top, which is okay if you're trying to, I'm going to go enter invoices, then I'm going to go over to job costs for a while and be able to do different things. But when you're trying to compare information, or you want to have one screen of information up, but not another, right, becomes very, very difficult. And so what we've added is the capability to take those tabs, and you can essentially make them become their own window. And so then if you have multiple monitors on your desktop at the office, you can drag that over to the other monitor. Or if you still only have one monitor, you can alt tab between them a lot easier. So to do that on the tab, you can right click and tell it to open in a new window. And it'll essentially will pop it out into its own window. Or you can go up into the label of the tab. You can click and drag with your mouse, and that'll automatically pull it out and put it into its own window. Here again, trying to make your day-to-day work easier, more efficient. The other capability, which is a big one, is our capabilities with employer tax. So we're seeing a lot more states and even localities implement either employee or employer-based taxes. And what we've really done is we really have taken the miscellaneous tax concept and really have bumped it up to be able to handle all of these capabilities and new requirements. So you see there, when you set up a miscellaneous tax, you now have the ability to indicate whether it is an employer tax. If you don't check the box, we assume it's an employee tax. We see this a lot anymore with the paid family medical leaves that various states are doing, where there's an employee component and an employer component. And so you would set up two miscellaneous taxes to accommodate both of those taxes. And then what we can do is then we can associate those taxes, those miscellaneous taxes, to the appropriate state tax authority, right? So in this case, we have an Oregon transit tax that is a tax on employers that needs to be calculated when we calculate Oregon payroll tax. So we associate that to the state authority. And so when the state calculates the miscellaneous tax or taxes will also calculate from that standpoint. So new capabilities. We have an entire session on this. So here at the conference. So be sure to attend that session, and you can take advantage of this and make your reporting a lot easier. And obviously make sure that you are calculating the appropriate taxes, and there are no surprises. For our estimating users, we've added new capabilities to help you manage your sheets. So as drawings are coming in for the estimate, you can have lots of drawings, hundreds of different sheets as part of that drawing, as part of that estimate. And so what we've done is we've allowed for the capability for you to create your own folder structure to help you manage all those different sheets. So you can create the necessary folder structure that you want that'll help you organize all of those sheets. And then you can drag and drop those sheets into those appropriate folders. So you can take all the sheets that are for foundation, put them in the foundation folder. If there's earthworks that need to be done, you can put them all there. However you want to manage it, you can then move those sheets into those appropriate folders. You can physically click on the top and drag them in there, or you can right click on each sheet and move them to a specific folder. A complete folder structure there to help you manage those estimates, foundation, underground, whatever the case may be. And then you can drag those sheets and keep those sheets all managed and easier to find going forward. Also in estimating, we've also added the capability for you to hide your estimates, so clean up your select job list, and also be able to search for those estimates. So what you see when you open up your select a job or you're looking for your estimates, you get this long list of estimates. Now you can go ahead and right click on an estimate and tell it to archive. Archive doesn't move it, doesn't remove it from the database. The data is all there. We're just going to remove it from that list. Makes it easier for you to manage and keep track of your open active estimates. We've also added the capability at the top of that screen for you to actually search for your estimate. So you can start typing the name of that estimate, and it'll automatically filter that list for you to get you to the estimate that you're looking for. On our PC mobile side, we've done a couple of things. One is we've enabled multiple user support within the PC mobile application. So before, you really couldn't log out, multiple users couldn't use it on the same device, etc. And so what we've done is we've allowed for that capability to happen. So a user can log in, right, do their work, and then they can log back out. And then another person can come on to the same device and be able to log in and do whatever it is that they need to do. So this is really designed for those project sites where potentially you have a tablet, workers don't have phones, or you don't want them to have PC mobile on their device. You can have it on the tablet. You can have the different employees come in and log in and enter their time, whatever the case may be, and then they can log out. Tablets are all optimal for this, right? Just given the amount of data from that standpoint, but it will work on phones if you're only trying to do one or two users from that standpoint. Also on the PC mobile, we've also done work to help capture time and make sure that the time that's captured out in the field is correct before it comes to the back office. So on the first screen there, you see that when an employee is entering their time on PC mobile, we've added the summary at the bottom. So we give them a summary for the day in terms of their total hours. We also provide a summary for that particular project, so they can sort of make sure that they've got all of their time entered for that given day. We also have a complete time summary, which is the second window. You can access this off the main page, where for a given day, you can see all of their time entries. You can see which project that they were on, which cost codes they were working, and what are those total hours. Here again, what we're trying to do is make sure it's accurate before it gets sent to the back office for processing. Then also on the PC mobile side, we've also done a lot of work with data syncing. Obviously, there's a lot of data moving back and forth between the back office and to the device and vice versa. We've done a couple releases this year already on data syncing. The biggest change is that we've really made the sync process into a two-step process. So the first step is what we call our metadata. It's all the critical data that we need inside of the app. Once that's done, it goes into the second step. And that second step is to go capture all the files, all the images, all of that information. But when it starts that second step, that is now a background task that happens behind the scenes. So once the first step is done, you actually can go use ProContractor and continue to use it on the job site rather than waiting for the entire sync process. We've seen a savings of over 90% in your ability to be able to use the PC mobile app application faster. So the sync process is much shorter, and then you can actually use the application while the data sync is completing. All right, those were sort of the big highlights. We've done a lot of other work, and we'll talk about how you can hear about all of those here in a second. All right, so from really being able to engage and as we move forward, I want to highlight the Viewpoint Network. So we've rolled this out to the ProContractor community. It's a great way to join other ProContractor customers. You can share experiences, tips, and tricks. We communicate quite heavily out into the network. It's a great way to get feedback, a lot of that. You also have the ability to earn rewards and those types of things. So please join the Viewpoint Network. It's easy, it's free. Visit viewpoint.com/network. You can sign yourself up and you'll be good to go. Viewpoint has a presence out on YouTube. So you can search for Viewpoint out there. And under the Viewpoint area, there are two ProContractor playlists. There's a ProContractor and a ProContractor tips and tricks. And out there, we're putting videos. Most of those videos are 5 minutes or less. They're really focused on tips and tricks, learning new capabilities that exist within the software, et cetera. So you can go out there and take a look at those. What we also do is we also put our release videos. So for every release, we put together a release video that highlights all of the new features, functionality that we've added to the ProContractor product suite. And you can go ahead and take a look and see all the things that are coming up in our next release. Suggestion box is also another way for you to stay engaged. And this one I really love. This is where you can go out to suggestion box available through our customer portal, and where you can add your ideas and thoughts as to what features or functionality should be added to ProContractor. All right, so little drum roll here for ProContractor 1. We had hoped to announce all of the details. We came up just a little bit short. We need a couple more weeks, some I's to dot and T's to cross. So we have more details coming, but we wanted to introduce this concept of ProContractor 1. It's really a comprehensive solution that we'll be talking about as we move forward. So be on the lookout for all of that information. You'll start to see it as we start to roll it out here in a couple of weeks or a month or so. So we're really excited. We really had hoped to be able to announce it, but just a few more I's to dot and T's to cross. So Tickler ProContractor 1 is coming. Okay, a couple of quick reminders before we get into the question and answer session. A couple of resources here again we want to highlight. So support is available on the Viewpoint customer portal, support.viewpoint.com. You can get in there. The knowledge base is available in there. You can connect with support through there. All of that great information is available to you there. There's the Viewpoint Academy. Viewpoint Academy is a great way to participate in a variety of trainings, instructor-led sessions. You actually get certification for a variety of different things. So it's a great way to learn more around the various products. And then the Viewpoint Network, we've already talked about that. Please go sign up. It's a great way to start connecting with other ProContractor customers and users and really start to maximize your use of ProContractor. Make sure you visit their booths. You can go out to the conference homepage and you can get access to them from that standpoint. Even though the conference is virtual, there's still great ways and opportunities for you to explore a variety of interactive experiences and networking opportunities here at Collaborate. Don't forget, you can connect with support, our Viewpoint Academy and our Viewpoint Network. You can find them at Viewpoint Central as part of the conference. You also have the opportunity to participate in a variety of games, earn badges, and win prizes. That's great. And then don't forget to visit our expo hall. This is where our technology partners and vendors are there. They have a variety of solutions. I mentioned two of them this year, Atrix and Invoice Pay. Go ahead, go check them out and see what is available out there for you. All right, now we are headed into our question and answer portion of our session. So if you haven't added your questions or feedback, into the chat area, go ahead and do that now. Appreciate everyone attending. Looking forward to all of your feedback. We will get those and we'll start the question and answer session here live here in just a moment. Thanks again for coming. And I look forward to seeing everyone in the other sessions. All right, great. We've got lots of questions and lots of feedback. I appreciate everyone who has been putting in their comments. We'll go through the list as best we can and until we run out of time, and then we'll follow up afterwards if there are any others. So there's a number of e-payment invoice pay questions that are coming through, which is great. And we also see some of our customers who are already using it are answering some of those questions too. So that is great. The question that came in is, does invoice pay cost extra? There is a monthly fee associated with the invoice pay solution. That is taken into account along with any rebates. And so the net of that is what either you pay or the net of that is what you get back every month into your company. The next question is the virtual credit card like a preloaded gift card, or is it the same as if I called my vendor and paid them with a credit card? They essentially get an email with a full credit card number, so they can run that manually, just like you picked up the phone, or you can submit that through the bank, etc. Some questions around vendor lien releases. Those work the same way. So those are not done as part of the e-payment process, but in different ways to handle that with e-payments. And we have a couple of customers who are doing it now that can provide that feedback. Lots of questions around Atrix also. This is a very popular question. Does Atrix integration mean that the Green Shades integration will stop? And the answer is no. We will continue to support both integrations for our compliance and regulatory reporting. Both are good solutions. They sort of attack the problem differently. It really depends on what you are most flexible with from that standpoint. Next question, does Atrix have required compliance state forms, including healthcare reporting? Atrix has a lot of compliance reports for every state. You can go out to their website, partner.atrix.com/ProContractor, and there is a link to their forms library that shows you exactly which forms that Atrix supports for every state. So you can see all of that information in terms of all of those forms from that standpoint. Which is better, Atrix or Green Shades? Here again, it all depends on what you're trying to do. A lot of our customers who are using Atrix really like the fact that it walks you through sort of in that fill in the blank PDF. And then you have, you can go through and then you can print it completely or actually sign up for the electronic services. The main differences, Atrix is included with ProContractor today as part of your service. And what that gets you is you are able to see all of the federal and state forms, and you can fill those forms out and print them from there. If you want to take advantage of the electronic filing, printing and mailing, year-end forms, and any of that, you can sign up for those services. A couple of different packages, either a la carte, or you can sign up for packages directly with Atrix from there. For green shades, you can contact your sales executive, and they can get you signed up for green shades from there. All right, lots of other questions coming through. We see lots of enhancement requests, which is great. So we will take these. Make sure you go out to the suggestion box. If you're not getting out there, go out there, please. It's a great way for us to get feedback and for me to get feedback, and we evaluate and weigh a lot of different things from that standpoint. Questions coming through. here again, will T&M invoices have the option to adjust? We're looking at that option right now. We're working through that and trying to figure that out. Another question came in: need a way to get rid of really old jobs? We have the ability to close jobs, and so they remove off the list. We also added capability about 12 months or so ago, where you can actually do that sort of in a bulk process. So you can go through and you can see all the jobs and sort of the end of month or end of quarter. You can sort of close jobs in bulk. So if you're looking for something different, be sure to reply back in chat and we can dig into it a little bit more. A couple of comments have been coming in about the new employer tax. It works today. There are some very specific use cases around Oregon TriMet tax and being location based, and that will be addressed in our year end release. But for a variety of other states that have or that have now or will be starting paid family medical leave taxes, right? That's part employee, part employer. It'll work just fine now. I highly recommend that you attend the session later on today. That's all about this component. And we're really trying to educate everyone so you can take advantage of it when the new year starts come January 1. Obviously, there's lots of logistics about trying to start in the middle of a quarter or in the middle of the year. So we're really trying to recommend everyone who wants to take advantage really start that in January. All right, going through the questions here. See some other great comments here. Someone commented that they were issuing a bonus check, and it doesn't quite calculate exactly right for those employees who are using the new W-4. We're well over that, where that, and will be addressed here shortly. So we'll have that taken care of. Great suggestions on some more project management integrations. From there, a question came in around archiving. Does it keep our archiving capability and estimating? Does it keep the same file structure name? And yes, it does. So it keeps all of that there, and it's all part of it from that standpoint. Going back through, double checking some other key questions here. Lien waivers. How do you get Atrix in ProContractor? I don't see it in the payroll module. It should automatically be there on your menu, assuming you're on the latest version or at least 3.114 version of ProContractor. You'll see it in the menu under year end. It'll say Atrix report filing. You should be able to see that. If you don't see that, contact us in support, and we will take a look. All right. A couple of questions really around ProContractor One. We're working through all of those details. We really were trying hard to get done and make a big announcement. Think of ProContractor One as a comprehensive, complete solution from estimating, project management, accounting, really for construction. It's really about taking the ProContractor product suite it is today and enhancing it, right? It's not going away. Let me repeat that. ProContractor's not going away. It's really about bundling and putting some other things together to provide a complete solution. So be on the lookout, probably here in the next several weeks or so. You'll start to see some information get tickled out. Any plans for predictive typing drop downs? Yes. So we are looking at that capability also for you to, you know, if I'm going to go look up a vendor or I'm in a AP invoice and I type a vendor number or name, right? Do I get a drop down with those vendors that are automatically matched? Yes, we are looking at that and trying to figure out the key areas to do that. A couple of questions really about printing W-2s, obviously. That is a key point. And some of the challenges in the past is always ProContractor has always processed and printed to a form. Now with Atrix, we have the ability, you can actually use Atrix and you can print those W-2s out of Atrix and you can print them on plain paper because Atrix will print the entire form. So you have all of those capabilities there. People want to know about closing jobs in bulk. So there's a menu option inside of the projects module that's called close jobs. I believe it's under setup. I would have to go back and double check. But in there, once you launch it, it'll ask for a date. It'll pull up all the list of jobs. You can pick which jobs that you want to close, and you can stay closed, and it'll go ahead and close those jobs for you quickly, simply, rather than having to do it one at a time. All right. Looks like we're just about out of time. We have a couple other questions that we'll follow up with afterwards. Thank you for attending this session. Give you a little bit of break before the next ProContractor session. Appreciate everyone attending. Make sure you attend the next couple of sessions. There are lots of great information. There's even one on how to edit and tweak a report, which is a very hot topic from there. So thank you. Be sure to visit the expo hall and engage with everything that is part of our Collaborate conference this year. For those of you who want to see CPE credits, the link is in the chat. So go ahead and grab that, open that up and complete that survey in order for you to get your credit. Great, everyone. I'm glad everyone was able to attend and we'll talk with everyone soon. Thanks.